work, that's a lot of timing, that's a lot of really precise movement. It works, it's highly effective. But if we can shortcut it, which I'm a big fan of, there's not a lot of shortcuts, this is one of those instances where it's a shortcut. It's more innovative in timing and position than it is like cheating the system. We're just beating this guy way earlier in the scramble than we would if we're waiting till late. Now, we gotta be really, really attentive, and we gotta make sure that when his belt buckle is facing the ceiling, I'm gonna drop the opposite elbow of the leg he's passing in between his legs. So this is what I'm talking about. I'm gonna be on a double leg. Just start on your knees, okay? We're gonna be back to our training wheels. I'm driving with my head, he's passing the leg. As he, freeze right here. As he passes the leg, when his belt buckle is facing the ceiling, I've gotta take opposite elbow of the leg he's passing. He's got my right leg he's passing. So my left elbow, because it's the opposite, is gonna drop down right in between his legs. Okay? And then as he continues to pass my leg, I'm just gonna dig up under his ankle and sit up into him. Okay? So I don't have to dive out, I don't have to swim my arm under, I don't have to do any of that. I just have to time it really, really, really good to where as he's passing my leg, I drop my elbow. I'm literally just dropping my elbow to the mat in between his legs and digging behind his knee. His is probably better than mine. Grab your partner and do it real quick. So double leg, and he passes our leg. No, you're double legging, Kale, because I want you to do the duck. So he double legs, Anthony passes. See how that elbow came in nice and clean? He didn't have to dive, didn't have to thread, didn't have to do anything. And then again, now go back to where you were. Then again, right here, it's just a battle, and we're just reading position. If Kale can drive and get into him a little bit here and straighten him out, then great. If not, then we go to that far ankle and wrestle in that position. But again, all I'm doing is as my leg's getting passed, boom, just dropping my elbow in between his legs. It'll come quick. It'll come real quick. As I'm double legging and as he's going to pass, it'll come real quick right here. Just drop it. Just drop it. And then as he continues to pass, I'm sitting up right here trying to get weight back towards him. Okay. And again, I might attack his elbow, I might do all kind of stuff, but as long as I'm driving forward and getting my feet back under my body, I'm fighting a good position. Okay? So that's what I want you to focus on. One more time. And it, like I said, it's gonna come quick. As I'm driving, boom, right there. Drop it, straight down. I just drop my left elbow in between his legs, and as he continues to pass, I'm just sitting up right here. Boom, driving. As soon as I get that leg over, I'm driving. I'm trying to work back here, get to my sprawl, work back into his body. Any questions? All right, so the quicker we can dig and sit up, the better chance we're gonna have of beating that guy right when we high leg over and drive into him. We're not gonna have to go far ankle and extend the scramble anymore. Questions? Anybody need to see it again? Super simple, timing is everything here, okay? So I bust him up with a good double right here. He goes past, drop, sit up right here, boom, driving in. See how this foot came over? Boom! As soon as that foot hit, it's like a hammer of a gun. As soon as it's not here, okay, what's going on? All right, cool. Let's figure it out. It's as soon as I dig, with this knee and he starts to pass and this foot hits here, boom, I'm into him. Okay? I'm into him right here. Now, lastly, don't over pursue this position. All right? Don't get your chest, even if you're up here, I've seen some guys get up here and get too high. This shouldn't feel good to you, okay? You shouldn't feel like you're in very much control here, especially if I have bottom shoulders. I should want to be low and crunching this guy up and trying to hold him on his back. Play there, go.